Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 6.3. In this section we will see step functions and the relation between the step functions and Laplace transforms. Some of the most interesting elementary applications of the transform method occur in the solution of linear differential equations with discontinuous or impulsive forcing functions. Equations of this type frequently arise in the analysis of the flow of current in electric circuits or the vibrations of mechanical systems. In this section and the following ones, we develop some additional properties of the Laplace transform that are useful in the solution of such problems. Unless a specific statement is made to the contrary, all functions appearing below will be assumed to be piecewise continuous and of exponential order so that their Laplace transform exists, at least for S sufficiently large. To deal effectively with functions having jump discontinuities, it is very helpful to introduce a function known as the unit step function or Heaviside function. This function will be denoted by UC and is defined by in this form. We have a piecewise function for all values of t less than c. The value of the function is 0. For the other values, the function is equal to 1. Just we have two different results for the value of the function according to these parts. And the graph of the unit step function can be given in this form. Until c, since the value of the function is 0, so it lies on the t-axis. And after c, since the value is equal to 1, so we have a horizontal line corresponding to the number 1 on the y-axis. Okay? And you see at c we have the discontinuity. This is called the jump discontinuity. If you remember the calculus one, the discontinuity point for the unit step function is the point C, okay, and it has jump discontinuity. If we consider the function 1 minus UCT, so until C now, since we look for the values of 1 minus UC of T, so in this case, for all values of t less than 0, so we have 0 for the value of UCT. So we 1 minus 0 becomes 1. Therefore, for this part, the value of 1 minus UCT is equal to 1 for all values of t less than c. And for the other values, we will get 0 since we have 1 for the value of UCT. So and 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, therefore we have 0 for all values of t bigger than or equal to c. And you see the graphs easily. And also, what is the difference of the two different unit step function? By supposing c is less than d, we have uc of t minus ud of t. And the difference has three parts, okay? Has three parts. For and if we suppose c is less than d, so according to the definition, for all values of t less than c we get 0, therefore the first one is equal to 0. And also t is less than d according to this inequality, therefore we get again 0 for the second one. So 0 minus 0 will be 0, which is corresponding to the first part. If t is between c and d, so now UCT is 1 and UDT is 0 since T is still less than D. So we have 1 for the second part. And if the value of T bigger than or equal to D, so we get 1 again for the first one since T is also bigger than C according to this one. And also T is bigger than D, so we have 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is the definition of the difference of the two unit step functions. And the graph will be in this form, namely this one until c we have 0, okay, until C we have 0, between C and D we have 1, and this point will be empty, and after D we have again 0 for the value of the function. Okay, this is the graph of the difference of the two different unit step functions. For example, let's write the function defined here in terms of the unit step function uc of t and sketch the graph of f. So this is the graph of f. For the first part we have a line actually, this is the graph of the line. You know how we can sketch the graph of a line in two-dimensional coordinate system. And the second one is a parabola actually, and this is the graph of the parabola. You can sketch yourselves. And the last one is a constant. Therefore, we have a horizontal line. So how can we state this function in terms of the unit step function? So we consider part by part. So for the first part, t is between 0 and 1. So we consider the right-hand point in this interval. Namely, the first unit step function will be u1 of t for the first part. And we know u1 of t is defined as it is equal to 0 until the number 1, and it is equal to 1 if t is bigger than or equal to 1. Okay. So to get 2 times t for the first part, by considering also u1 of t, until the number 1, since the value of u1 is equal to 0, for the coefficient of 2 times t, so we should get 1 actually. Therefore, we write 1 minus u1 of t, 1 minus u1 of t for all values of t less than 1, such that when we write 0 for u1 of t, so we get 1. Therefore, for all values of t until the number 1, we get 1 for 1 minus u1 of t. So if you write as a coefficient this function here, so we obtain a statement for the given function in terms of the unit step function. Namely, we write 2 times t times 1 minus u1 of t, 1 minus u1 of t, because we have 0 for u1 of t, and 1 minus 0 is equal to always 1 for all values of t between 0 and 1, according to the definition of the unit step function. Okay, therefore the first part of the function is 2 times t, 1 minus u1 of t. And for the second part, we have the interval from 1 to 3. So if we have two positive numbers for the left hand and right hand point for the variable t, so we consider the difference of the unit step function, since we have 1 for all values of t between C and D. Instead of C and D, we have 1 and 3, and in this interval the value of the difference is always equal to 1. Therefore, actually we can consider this is a multiplication of this one and the difference of the unit step function, u1 of t minus u3 of t, u1 of t minus u3 of t. Okay, since we obtain 1 always for the difference according to this definition. And for the next one, t is equal to or bigger than 3, therefore we consider u3 of t, and according to the definition of u3 of t, u3 of t is 0 or 1 if t is less than 3, if t is bigger than or equal to 3. Namely, we get always 1. We get always 1 for all values of t bigger than 3. And we have the same condition for the last part. Therefore, we consider u3 of t as a coefficient of 2 since we have 1, which means it does not affect the statement of the function f actually. But we write this function in terms of the unit step function. So 2 times u3 of t. And by gathering them without considering the intervals, because the intervals are included in the definitions of the unit step functions. Therefore, in this case, after writing the function in terms of the unit step function, we don't need to write the conditions for the variable t. So directly we can write f of t is equal to 2 times t times 1 minus u1 of t plus 4 minus t minus 1 squared times the difference, you see, plus 2 times u3 of t. Okay, this is the statement of the function f given in the example in terms of the unit step function. Okay, according to the endpoints here, we take the unit step functions and we should get 1. Okay, so we have a theorem which is very important. If the Laplace transform of little f is equal to some function of s, which is denoted by bigger f of s, for s is bigger than a and a is a non-negative number, and if c is a positive constant, then the Laplace transform of the multiplication of the unit step function and the function f at t minus c is equal to e to the power minus c times s times the Laplace transform of little f, or we write e to the power minus c times s times bigger f of s. If you consider the inverse Laplace transform, conversely, we can write the inverse Laplace transform of this one will be equal to this one. Okay, you see, the inverse Laplace transform of the multiplication written here, e to the power minus c times s times some function of s, is equal to uc of t times little f of t minus c. And c is obtained by taking the coefficient of s without minus. For example, let's directly find the Laplace transform of the unit step function uc of t. So here, we don't consider the first one because we don't have any inverse Laplace transform here. So from here, we consider f of t minus c is equal to 1. F of t minus c is equal to 1. Therefore, we have a constant function for the function little f. So for every value of the independent variable, so we will get 1 always. Therefore, according to the theorem written here, the Laplace transform of uc of t times 1 is equal to e to the power minus c times s times the Laplace transform of little f, which is equal to 1. And the Laplace transform of 1 is equal to 1 over s, you know. Namely, e to the power minus c times s times 1 over s. Another example, the Laplace transform of u2 of t times t minus 2, namely f of t minus c is corresponding to t minus 2 according to the theorem, you see, which means c is equal to 2, and also c is obtained from this one because c is corresponding to 2 here. So according to the formula, it is equal to e to the power minus 2 times s, e to the power minus 2 times s times the Laplace transform of the function little f. So f of t minus 2 is equal to t minus 2. And from here we can say actually f of t is equal to t, because we have the same terms here. F of t is equal to t, which means we need to find the Laplace transform of t, which is equal to 1 over s square, if you remember. Therefore, we obtain e to the power minus 2 times s over s square. Okay. Another example, let's compute the inverse Laplace transform of, let's write here, the inverse Laplace transform of the function 2 times e to the power, 2 times e to the power 2s minus 2s over s square minus 4. So since we have the inverse Laplace transform, we use the second formula written here, namely the Laplace transform of the multiplication e to the power minus e to the power minus c times s bigger f of s is equal to uct f of t minus c, uct f of t minus c. Therefore, we consider bigger f of s here. Bigger f of s is equal to two over, namely we don't consider the exponential function because it is corresponding to this one. Except the exponential function, the other terms will form bigger f of s. Therefore, we have 2 over s square minus 4. 2 over s square minus 4. So according to the definition, c is equal to 2. C is equal to 2. And we need to find the inverse Laplace transform of bigger fs, which is equal to f of t. So to find the inverse Laplace transform of this one, we don't have directly a formula for this function, so we consider the factors, namely we will write, we will find the partial fractions of this rational function. 2 over s square minus 4 is equal to a over s minus 2 plus b over s plus 2. So we have 2 is equal to a times s plus 2 plus b times s minus 2. So from here, to find a and b, we write, for example, 2 to get 1, to get a. When write 2 for s, so we have 2 is equal to a times 4. So a is equal to 1 over 2. Similarly, when write minus 2 for s, we get 2 is equal to b times minus 4. So b is equal to minus 1 over 2. Therefore, the inverse Laplace transform of the function bigger f of s is equal to the Laplace transform, the inverse Laplace transform of the partial fraction written here, 1 over 2 e to the s minus 2 plus minus 1 over 2 s plus 2. And using the linearity property for the inverse Laplace transform, so we obtain 1 over 2 is equal to, if you remember, the Laplace transform of exponential function is equal to 1 over s minus a, Okay, so we have 2 for a, we get e to the power 2t by considering the inverse Laplace transform, namely e to the power a times t is equal to the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s minus a. Okay. Minus 1 over 2 times e to the power minus 2 times t. Okay, since a is equal to minus 2 for the second one. And we should obtain t minus c according to the formula. This is little f of t. Little f of t. And t minus c, namely c is equal to 2, f of t minus 2. F of t minus 2 is equal to 1 over 2 times e to the power 2 times 2 times t minus 4 minus 1 over 2 e to the power minus 2 times t minus 2. Okay. And the inverse Laplace transform therefore will be equal to u c t, namely c is equal to 2, therefore we write u2 of t times little f of t minus 2 according to the formula. Okay, and f of t minus 2 is written here, so by multiplying this one by u2 of t we obtained inverse Laplace transform using the second formula. Okay. So another formula which is obtained from the theorem. So we know actually the Laplace transform UCT times f of t minus c is equal to e to the power minus c times s times f of s, bigger f of s. Okay, where the Laplace transform of little f is equal to this one. Okay, the Laplace transform of little f is equal to bigger f of s. So if you write t plus c for the independent variable t here, namely if you consider u c t times g of t, Laplace transform of UCT plus g of t is equal to e to the power minus c times s times the Laplace transform of gt plus c. Okay, gt plus c, because here we have f of t, so instead of t we have t plus c. Okay, e to the power minus c times s, e to the power minus c times s times the Laplace transform of the function gt plus c. Therefore we have here another formula obtained from the theorem. For example, let's find the Laplace transform of the function 3t plus 1 times u c t, okay, u1t, instead of c we have 1. So according to this formula, so instead of g of t we have 3t plus 1. Okay, g of t is 3 times t plus 1. So from here C is also equal to 1. So we have e to the power minus s, the Laplace transform of the function. So we write t plus 1, namely g of t plus 1, since c is equal to 1. So from here, t plus 1 is equal to 3t plus 3 plus 1. So we have 3 times t plus 4. So we have 3t plus 4. So from here we obtain e to the power minus s. Using the linearity property, we have the Laplace transform 3 times the Laplace transform of t plus 4 times the Laplace transform of 1. So we have e to the power minus s times 3 1 over s squared. Using the formula for the power function, 1 factorial over s 1 plus 1, so we have 1 plus s squared plus 4 times 1 over s. Okay, 4 times 1 over s. This is the answer of the question. 1 over s squared. Okay, and you see the answer here. And we don't remember, we should, yes, okay, this is true. Another example, find inverse transform of this function. So for the linearity of the inverse transform, this function, because it can be written as 1 over s squared minus e to the power minus 2s over s squared, okay. The inverse Laplace transform 1 over s is equal to t. You see, from using by using the formula for the power function, the Laplace transform of t to the power n is equal to n factorial over s to the power n plus 1. And by considering the inverse Laplace transform, so we obtain this one, t, like the previous example. And for the second one, we use the formula, which one, let's consider the formula, the Laplace transform of e to the power minus c times s times bigger f of s is equal to u c of t little f of t minus c. Therefore, here when we consider that coefficient of s for the exponential, so c is equal to 2, so we write u2 of t, and 1 over s square is corresponding to bigger f of s, and we know its inverse Laplace transform, which is equal to t. Therefore, f of t is equal to t, which means f of t minus 2 will be equal to t minus 2. Okay, therefore we obtain this one. So the another important formula is stated in this theorem. It contains another very useful property of Laplace transforms that is somewhat analogous to the given in the previous theorem. So the Laplace transform of the multiplication of the exponential function of little f of t is equal to directly bigger f of c minus c. It is enough to find the Laplace transform of little f, and by finding the value of this function bigger f at c minus c, directly we find the Laplace transform of this multiplication. Okay, so we have a function and it is multiplied by the exponential function, and its Laplace transform is easily found just by finding the Laplace transform of little f. Okay, inversely, if so to find the inverse Laplace transform of the function bigger f of c minus s minus c, So it is equal to e to the power c times t times little f of t. Okay. For example, let's find the inverse Laplace transform of the function 1 over a square minus 4s plus 5. So if you write the number 5 as plus 4 and plus 1, so we obtain this denominator, okay, because except the number 1, the other terms are corresponding to the square of s minus 2, you see. So we have plus 1 here. So we can consider this is equal to bigger f of s minus 2 by considering s minus 2 as a variable. So from here, bigger f of s will be, bigger f of s will be 1 over s square plus 1. So in this current form, we don't have any formula directly for finding its inverse transform, but by writing this function like this one and finding the bigger f of s and using this formula, so now we have directly a formula for the inverse transform for this function, which is equal to sine t. If you remember, the inverse Laplace transform of bigger f of s is equal to sine t, if you remember the table for the Laplace transform. Therefore, since the function, the given function is equal to f of s minus 2, so we obtain using the formula written here, e to the power c times t, since c is equal to 2, so e to the power 2 times t times the Laplace transform of bigger f of s inverse Laplace transform, which is equal to sine t, using the formula written here. So we should gather the formulas to see very well. We know if the Laplace transform of little f is equal to bigger f of s, also we can define the inverse Laplace transform using this formula. And we have the linearity property for the inverse Laplace transform, and you see the formulas for some functions, elementary functions like cosine, sine, the power function and exponential function, you should know very well. And the Laplace transform of the multiplication of the exponential and some function of t is equal to bigger f of c minus t, where the Laplace transform, inverse Laplace transform of little f of s, or let's write in this case the Laplace transform of little f is equal to bigger f of s, bigger f of s. And the Laplace transform using this one, we have also formula for the inverse Laplace transform. Conversely, the inverse Laplace transform of this one is equal to this one, okay, e to the power c times t times little f of t, or the inverse Laplace transform of bigger f of s. They are important formulas. And also we have another formula in terms of the unit step function, you see, we saw. And inversely, this is also equal to e to the power minus c times s bigger f of s. And inversely, the inverse Laplace transform of this one written here is equal to this function. And the Laplace transform of the first derivative is equal to this one. We saw this formula in the previous section. Thank you very much.